Hi, welcome back to Arm Wraps. My name is Randy Miller, and I'm just going to show you the process of wrapping both sides of the door. So what I did was I added 2 inches, and I cut the vinyl already to speed up the time. And before I do anything, I used rubbing alcohol and water, and I made sure everything is nice and clean around the edges. And today I'm using the Belvian vinyl, and as you can see right behind me, I'm not sure if you can see all that. Yeah. Everything white, this color right here, is wrapped by Belvian. Okay, so what I do is, this is the back side of the door first. I always hit the back side, and I wrap it all the way to the edge right here. And then when I do the front, I go up front, and I wrap it at the edge. So it's vinyl on top of vinyl, so it makes a lot stickier. Okay, so let's go ahead and start this project. If you got any comments or questions, comment down below. If you like my stuff, subscribe to me. I'm gonna start doing more and more videos, on how-to videos and the projects I'm working on, and all kinds of things. So now what I do is went down about 4 inches, and I tap it down one side. And the trick is right here. This is the back side right here. First, you do the back side first, and then do the front. So I just kind of lay it down and tack it on there. That's one little trick that I came up with. So instead of second guessing where the door is, okay, use a squeegee, put the felt nip on there, and pulling the back down. And of course there's things, little hinges we're supposed to go in the way that I just kinda sometimes I use my fingers to do it. And I'm going to use a heat gun at the very end, sink it in even more. I'm just tacking it down. Okay, once it's all tacked down, make sure all the air bubbles out. Let's see. That's good. Okay, next thing I do is I pinch the area. Let's make sure everything's in view. Yeah. Pinch the area. See where exactly the corn is. I do a 45 degree angle cut. And hit all the corners first. Now this is the bottom door right over there. So, okay, there's certain ways to go about the right way to do this. I'll show you why. I'll tell you why. Let's make sure everything is lined up. Oops. There you go. Alright. So I get the top part. Actually, this is the bottom part. On this, what I do is I overlap it, just do the 45 degree angle, overlap it. This is vinyl on top of vinyl, and that's the best way to do it for me, and everyone's a little different. Now I'm doing a cut right in the middle, I'm doing a 45 degree angle cut. So reason why I do that, so when I put the other vinyl on, this, if you go like this, if you can't feel anything, that's great. But if you do a straight cut like this, when you put the second vinyl on, you'll see that lip coming out. So I recommend doing a 45 degree angle cut. All right, same thing. Same thing, overlapping it. Okay. Again, 45 being cut. Now for the top, for the sides, I guess. And I'm just kind of using my thumb, pulling it tight. Now with this right here, I'm just going straight down. Okay, just straight down. Same thing. Straight down. Another 45 degree angle cut. Trying to stay out of your guys' way. Sometimes the vinyl pinches over here and what I like to do is use the heat gun a little bit. It softens up the vinyl and you can stretch it a little bit easier. Now when you use a heat gun, it activates the glue even more. And I'll show you real quick. Anytime I get done with one side, I always use a heat gun. Here, actually what I'm going to do is I'm going to pierce that. This is where the screws come in. I just do an X. Now, what I'm doing, I'm softening up the vinyl. You can see the vinyl dancing. When it's dancing, that means it's time to play it. Okay, next thing I do all the corners, and I just add a little heat to it. You can see it dancing a little bit. It just sinks it in. And sometimes you can see how it bubbles up. Anytime you add a little heat to it, you can always see where it didn't connect. You want a good connection. So this is where I'm at now, is I'm going to do vinyl on top of vinyl. Come on, let me cut these out real quick. This is where the hinge. As you can see, I'm doing this kitchen right now. I'm in Florida. I do travel. I do luxury homes, yachts, buildings, commercial use, stuff like that. So if you need anything, give me a call or email me and say, hey, I'd like to, for you to do my kitchen or yacht or boat or whatever. Okay. Next thing I do is next area. Make sure the wood grain's going this way. Again, go lay down. I'll do a little walkthrough after this little video of what I've done so far. I'm trying to show you. just pushing down again. Flip it. And this is actually my early's final. It gets out most of bubbles, but when you add a little heat to it, it brings out even more. And then the heat actually seals it up. Okay. Once again. Right in the corner. You pinch it a little bit and know exactly where the corner's at. Do 45. Pinch it. 45, 45. Okay. At the very end, I use the heat. The heat just activates it. Now this one right here, what I do is I go straight down. Change the look of this kitchen in a couple days, 3 to 4 days. It's a big kitchen too, so I got a thing to do, so I'm gonna be here about 3 days, 3 to 4 days. Okay, again, 45. You can kind of see how thin I can slice them. Of course, there's a new razor too. I try to change my razors quite often because if you have a clean razor, it goes much better. Okay. Straight down. Now I'm going to do the 45 degree angle cut again. The reason why I do that is so it doesn't grab, you don't grab it. So definitely a 45 degree angle cut. Every saw is a little different, just like any other thing you do. This is just the way I do it. This is the way I like to do it because everything is nice and clean. So if you do it differently, if you do it better, do the video, show me. I would love to see how you do it. You can see prices on the rmwrapstore.com with the Belvian and the Dynac material. I usually start in the middle and it's just easier for me to find where the door is and start it too. I like to seal it up one more time with the new vinyl. times it. Get an air bubble in there. That's the reason why I put a little heat to it, because the heat pops up the air bubbles and also activates the glue even more. Okay. Let's go back to the door.
Let's see if I can get you guys over here real quick. Sorry about the connection. Let's do a little walkthrough, guys. That's the end product. I'll do another video after this, because it's a bad connection. Hopefully it lightens up a little bit. But everything you see is white, it's wrapped. All right, let me do another video, and then I'll put it on YouTube. Thanks for watching, guys.